chickens, chickens.
So I live in this house with my husband Mark, my daughter Julia. Right now we have about 500 sheep, 2 border collies, a Great Pyrenees, and also about 25 chickens. I live in the town of Leiden, which has got about 600 to 700 people. This is New England, and it's very, very cold here in the winter, and it's very white outside. So I feel like color is so warm and inviting and enveloping and cozy. So I just plaster color all over my house. In textiles, in paint colors, paintings, lampshades that are decorated. I don't have anything beige in my house. In my living room, I actually, every wall is a different color. They all go together. People would say that's just nuts and psychotic, but because they're analogous, they're close to each other in tones, it holds it all together. So my husband and I have been married for 31 years, and you know, like all first married couples, we had nothing. And so our relatives started giving cast-off furniture. And my table in my kitchen is from my mom and dad, and it's oak veneer, and it's all chipped, and it's worn out. But I love it because it's 31 years of our life in that table. Every time my mom comes to the house, she says, "You really gotta get that done again." And I say, "Mom, I like it. I like the layers." And that's how I feel about a house. Let it get dents and nicks and everything. And that doesn't matter, you can always fix it. So I got this phone call from this young woman photographer, and she said, "I'm writing for this website called House, and could she come take some pictures?" And the story went live in September, and it started getting these comments. So every night I would go on, read the comments, and it became clear to me that people were terrified of color. So I was able to do a book proposal about writing about color and write a book, and it was all because of the House article. I like to paint furniture. I don't paint really old furniture. It's usually, I use like a 100-year rule. I have a set of sideboard, dining room table, and these great carved chairs, and they came from my aunt, Jenny, when she died, and nobody in her family wanted them. It was an ugly oak color, and I didn't like it, but I put a wash of oil, black oil paint on it, and like the piece came to life just by changing the color. So I'm not really afraid to change the color of a piece of furniture if it's not working for me. I have my grandma's Hoosier cabinet, which I painted bright orange. I have my great aunt's beautiful sideboard, and it's bright fire engine red. It makes a piece of furniture or a house have a little more soul than something, say, you just bought brand new.
I like the idea that I can get up in the morning and she is all excited at the breakfast table because she decided 2 a.m. she was going to paint a room. In my mind, like, why the hell would you ever do something like that? But in her mind, it's perfectly acceptable. I would be nuts to tell her she could or could not do something. You know, that would just destroy her creativity.
About 4 years ago, I decided I needed a dedicated studio because I wanted to do some teaching. So there was a cement pad, and I was able to put a 2-story addition on it. And in the basement is my studio. The walls in that room are white. But when you go in, all you see is all my things that are all over the walls, because everything I do is in color. I've always loved oil paintings, but couldn't afford them, so I figured I would teach myself to paint and just started fooling around with it. And so now my house is full of these oil paintings. So we raised pigs 1 year, and my first pig, her name was Pinky. So I thought it would be really cool to immortalize Pinky in an oil painting. So I painted Pinky the pig. And so many people have wanted to buy that, but I will not let Pinky go. I went to my friend's house in Maine, and she asked me if I would bring some fabric paint and paint her lampshades for her. So I didn't know what I was doing, but I figured, what the heck, I'll try it. So I put all these patterns all over it, stuck it on her lamp. And then when I moved here, I was like, man, I am gonna put these things all over my house. So I get a white lampshade with a styrene backing, and I use a textile paint called Jacquard, and it's a translucent. So when the light comes through it, it almost looks like stained glass. And I put different colors, pretty bright, around it. And when you drive down the hill and you see these lamps lit up, it's just so pretty. I love this home because it's so old and it has so much history. I always wanted to live in a really old house.
I was raised on a small farm. As the crow flies, it's probably less than 3 miles from here. You can't really see much more than a quarter mile, half mile in any direction. It's really nice having small pastures, small vistas, and a mile down the road, it might be a totally different thing.
Look at him. Isn't he a looker?
I wanted to raise my child on a small farm. She has a certain amount of rural country sense. She'll never admit she does, but I can see it. It's just during lambing season. Once in a while, we get a lamb that's chilled or needs a little extra help. And it was one time where it didn't look too good and this and that. And Julia's comment is, it's not dead yet. So most little kids wouldn't see, are not exposed to life and death like that.
I feel very lucky to be living in this family. Like, I have very supportive parents and I really wouldn't have it any other way.
So this house is like a really nice family house. And you just walk in and you know, you feel loved in it. Ever since we've lived here, we've had Thanksgiving here. So that's like one of the greatest memories for me of this house, is everybody gathering here and having this pretty, you know, raucous party in this living room and then eating in the dining room. And now the kids are all, you know, they're in college, they're moving away, getting their first jobs, and they're not gonna be able to come anymore. But I hope that when they go on and their lives continue, that they remember Thanksgiving at Aunt Kristen's house.